Hello everyone, it's a pleasure to see you again in this video. Today, we're going to talk about a very peculiar incident, a boiler becoming pregnant. Yes, in quotation marks. This is a malfunction case of a fire tube boiler, water tube design, chain grate stoker, and belly fired bottom firing system imported from China. Such a malfunction is not uncommon in bottom firing boilers, where the flame is located directly beneath the steam drum, similar to how we'd heat a pot from the bottom using firewood. This boiler has a rated capacity of 5 tons horsepower and uses Indonesian coal as fuel. The issue? The steam drum ballooned outward, and I jokingly call it a pregnant boiler because it swells like a belly. We'll look into three key points. What caused this boiler to become pregnant? How was the issue resolved? What can be done to prevent this from happening again? Let's begin. Part 1. Causes of the incident. If you've been following DIVI's channel, you might have seen our video, Why is water treatment important for boilers? Let's replay a short clip from that video.
The heat from the flame will transfer to the water through the tube wall. Thanks to the continuous heat absorption by the water, the tube wall temperature is maintained at a certain low temperature. However, because sediment clings to the tube wall, it prevents the contact of water with the tube wall, leading to the tube not being cooled and causing the tube wall temperature to rise nearly to the temperature of the flame. The tube wall, heated to a high temperature, will change the mechanical properties of steel, making the steel soften, change hardness, and simultaneously reduce the steel's load-bearing capacity.
As shown, this swelling of the steam drum shell was caused by long-term scale buildup, which blocked heat transfer, causing overheating of the steel. Under high internal pressure, this section of the drum expanded and bulged. Upon site inspection, a significant amount of deposits was found at this location. These deposits had broken off from the evaporator tubes above and settled at the bottom of the drum. The factory was running continuously and could not schedule downtime for cleaning, which led to the failure. So, is this incident dangerous? Absolutely. It's extremely hazardous. We were fortunate that no boiler explosion occurred. That wraps up part 1. Let's move on to part 2. Part 2. How we fixed it. After receiving a request for support, DIVI conducted a site survey and proposed two solutions. Option 1. Cut and replace the bulged section with new material. Option 2. Reinforce the swollen section, local plate strengthening. To decide between these, we first performed ultrasonic thickness testing on the swollen drum wall. Results showed that the remaining wall thickness ranged from 11 millimeters to 14 millimeters, which, given the drum's diameter, still met the pressure rating of 10 bar. Hence, both parties agreed to reinforce instead of replacing, minimizing downtime and avoiding production losses. The replacement option would have required a long lead time due to material sourcing and welding procedures, which would have seriously impacted the client's operations. So we went with the reinforcement plan, installing vertical stiffener bars on the bulged area. After a full night of hard work, DIVI's team completed the reinforcement. The client then conducted a hydrostatic pressure test before resuming operations, and the boiler returned to normal working condition. Part 3, preventing the same problem. This type of failure is common in belly-fired boilers. If you're using this design, please take note of these preventive measures. Regularly clean scale deposits inside the boiler, especially at the steam drum area beneath the fire. Ideally, clean weekly or bi-weekly. The more frequent, the safer. Consistently use water treatment chemicals to minimize scaling. For more information, check our video, Why Use Boiler Chemicals? Blow down the boiler regularly to remove sludge and sediments. For a detailed guide, watch our video, How to Perform Boiler Blowdown. By following these three steps carefully, I can confidently say, your boiler will never get pregnant again. That's the end of today's sharing on a boiler failure case we handled. We hope it's been useful to all boiler operators. See you in another video. Next time, I'll show you the new boiler installation replacing this damaged one. Wishing everyone good health, success, and lots of luck.